Hi, Brivaracetam or Briviact is the second generation of Levetiracetam or Keppra. And this medicine is generally very well tolerated. It can be treating focal and generalized epilepsy, and it has much less psychiatric side effects than Keppra does. And it is possible to switch directly from Levetiracetam to Brivaracetam, as we will explain in details today. So let's talk about Brivaracetam for epilepsy and answer the most common 10 questions that you need to know. And at the end of the video, I will give you all the best scenarios that we should use Brivaracetam in. First question, what types of epilepsy Brivaracetam treats? Brivaracetam is a broad-spectrum anti-seizure medication. It is approved by the FDA for focal epilepsy in children 1 month old and older, and there are multiple studies to show efficacy in primary generalized tonic-clonic seizures and generalized epilepsy, but more studies are needed for the FDA approval. Brivaracetam is also used for status epilepticus with very long and stubborn seizures, and it is given IV in the vein, and it has very fast transition to the brain, which makes it a great medicine for this epilepsy and seizure emergency. And there are lots of studies now being done for status epilepticus and Brivaracetam use. Second question, how does Brivaracetam work and what is the mechanism of action? Brivaracetam works in a unique mechanism by inhibiting the synaptic vesicle glycoprotein 2A, SV2A, like Levetiracetam, but it is much more potent and specific for that, and it is 10 times more specific for the SV2A than Levetiracetam, and it has less interaction with other targets in the brain, which can explain why it has less psychiatric side effects. How to dose Brivaracetam? Brivaracetam is available in multiple forms, in IV, oral capsules, and in solutions, which is great for flexibility of use. We start with Brivaracetam 50 mg twice a day, and this can be the treatment dose and everything you need. And we can increase the dose further based on seizure control and tolerability to a maximum dose of 100 mg twice a day. And we have used much higher doses than this, off-label, of course. We can decrease the initial dose to 25 mg twice a day in other cases with issues of tolerability or elderly, they are more sensitive to medications. In children, we give Brivaracetam based on the weight. We start with 0.5 to 1 milligram per kilogram per day in two divided doses, and we increase that based on tolerability and seizure control, and the maximum dose is 4 milligram per kilogram per day in two divided doses. In case of renal impairment, if it is mild to severe, there is no need to adjust Brivaracetam, and in complete renal failure and on hemodialysis, we know that Levetiracetam, the first generation, gets filtered by at least 50% with dialysis, and we add extra doses after dialysis, but we do not know exactly what happens in Brivaracetam, and we expect that it does also decrease with dialysis, and hopefully more studies will be done to clarify this question. And in liver failure, we decrease the initial dose to 25 milligram instead of 50 milligram twice a day, and decrease the target dose to 75 milligram instead of 100. So we're just gonna decrease the levels because the liver processes the medicine, so it makes sense if the liver is not working well to give less medicine. And on this point, it is important to know that Brivaracetam gets processed in the liver, not like Levetiracetam, which usually is processed in the kidneys. So it can interact with other medications that intervene with liver enzymes, such as valproic acid or Depakote and carbamazepine or Tegretol. Please let me know down in the comments, what is your experience with Brivaracetam? And is it really better than Levetiracetam or Keppra? What can I do if Brivaracetam is not working for me? Well, there are multiple causes why any anti-seizure medication is not working. Most commonly that we did not push the medicine high enough dose, means we did not increase it all the way to be effective, or we did not wait long enough for the medicine to take effect. So we should usually wait between 3 and 6 months to judge if the medicine is working or not. And sometimes we just have difficult to control epilepsy and seizures, that is called drug-resistant epilepsy, which happens in about a quarter of the time, 25%. What are the side effects of Brivaracetam? Brivaracetam in general is a very well-tolerated medication. Common side effects include dizziness, drowsiness, fatigue, and irritability, which usually improves with time and as your body gets used to the treatment. Studies have shown that Brivaracetam has better psychiatric side effect profile than Levetiracetam. However, it can still cause depression, anxiety, irritability, and mood issues, but to a much lesser extent and to a less percentage of people. The way I see levetiracetam than brivaracetam is like this. You know, levetiracetam is much more aggressive and having lots of psychiatric side effects, and brivaracetam has less side effects. Like most other anti-seizure medications, brivaracetam has the warning for suicidal ideation, so it is important to counsel the patients about this. In multiple studies looking at the psychiatric side effects of levetiracetam and brivaracetam, when the patients were switched after having psychiatric side effects from levetiracetam, the Keppra, to brivaracetam, Briviact, there was a decrease in the psychiatric side effects anywhere between 33 and 83% of the patients, which is considered very significant. This leads to the other question: if I'm taking levetiracetam, can I switch to brivaracetam and how? Luckily, yes, you can switch from levetiracetam to brivaracetam, and this is the only medicine that we can make the switch right away overnight. The ratio that we use is 1 to 10 or 1 to 15 from brivaracetam and levetiracetam. So if you were taking 1000 milligrams of levetiracetam or Keppra, you can take 100 milligrams or even 75 milligrams of brivaracetam, and that will be the same effect. Can I drive or drink alcohol with brivaracetam? Because brivaracetam causes drowsiness and dizziness and sleepiness at the beginning of the treatment, you should avoid driving at that time until your body gets used to the new treatment. And in case of alcohol, it is advised to avoid alcohol with anti-seizure medications so that do not combine the effect of drowsiness and sleepiness and also the psychiatric side effect. How to stop brivaracetam if it's not working for me? Stopping anti-seizure medication should be very cautious and under your doctor's supervision. We cannot stop anti-seizure medications suddenly like cold turkey. We should always wean it off with time. So usually it takes about 1 to 2 months until we wean off brivaracetam gradually. And the only time we stop it suddenly is when there is an allergic reaction happening. Is brivaracetam safe in pregnancy and breastfeeding? At this point, we do not have human studies on the effect of brivaracetam on pregnancy that are reliable or long-term. If you get pregnant on brivaracetam, it is highly recommended to you enroll yourself with a drug registry and monitoring studies that are responsible for tracking those changes if they happen, and that will be great to add to the science and answer this question more reliably. In animal studies, there were some harm to the fetus seen, but we do not know the effects on the humans yet. The same with breastfeeding. We know that brivaracetam can be excreted in the breast milk. However, we know that breastfeeding is very, very valuable and very important for the baby, especially in the brain development and intelligence. So it is a discussion between you and your neurologist if we can breastfeed with brivaracetam or not. Now, understanding all the properties of brivaracetam, these are the best scenarios we can use the medicine in. The first is that if we have a patient with new onset epilepsy and seizures that are frequent and we do not have time to titrate other medications and we need the rapid control, and this is great with brivaracetam because the first treatment dose, 50 milligrams twice a day, is the target treatment dose. The second scenario, if somebody is taking levetiracetam and it works very well for them, however, they're having some psychiatric side effects, anxiety, depression worsening, we can switch them to brivaracetam to hopefully have less psychiatric side effects. Other cases, if the patient is in the hospital admitted for status epilepticus or frequent seizures, we can give this medicine IV, and that can cure and help the seizures very quickly. And in elderly, it is a cleaner medicine with less side effects, so we can give it to elderly patients more than 65 who have seizures. But it is very important that we should adjust the doses and start slower. Instead of 50 milligrams twice a day, we start with 25 milligrams, maybe once a day or twice a day. It depends on their tolerability. This was one anti-epileptic drug working in one mechanism. There are multiple other anti-epileptic drugs that works in different mechanisms in the brain. And to learn about all those anti-epileptic drugs and which one is good for you and which one works well, you can see this video. I put all the anti-epileptic drugs in very easy way to understand and stay healthy. And see you in the next one. Salam.